With the second wave of the coronavirus now well underway in most Canadian provinces, Quebec's situation is now described as critical. COVID-19 cases in Quebec has topped 100,000, with more than 800 new infections reported Sunday. Ontario is not faring any better, as the province saw more than 1,000 new cases over the weekend, bringing the total to more than 70,000. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau urged Canadians to continue observing public health practices in order to flatten the curve again. To make sure that Canada has all its bases covered, Trudeau said the government is also investing $214 million in Canadian companies to develop made-in-Canada vaccines. Trudeau said, should a small amount of the vaccine become available early next year, priority will be given to the most vulnerable and the frontline workers.
We are waiting to ensure that those vaccines are effective and further that they will be safe for Canadians.
Filipino-Canadian Dr. Iris Radeb agreed that there's still a long way to go before a vaccine becomes available. Radeb said 10 companies are now in phase 3 of their trials, but it is still uncertain when these vaccines will be ready.
There have been parang mga complications in some people they've given the vaccine to, so they're looking at that closely because they don't want also to risk yung side effects na mag-outweigh ng benefit ng vaccine. So, you know, with everything going well, hopefully by next year.
BC's top doctor Bonnie Henry has officially declared a second wave in the province, with cases now totaling more than 12,000. Radev warned that recent modeling shows that the second wave can last up to February, but if health practices are followed, this can lead to a faster trending down.
If you look at the projections, it looks like it will be increasing all the way up to February of next year. So I think because we have been able to succeed before, no, at the first peak, we know that we can do it. We just have to follow directives.
The total number of COVID-19 cases in Canada has now reached more than 216,000, and experts said Thanksgiving gatherings 2 weeks ago may have contributed to the increase. Meanwhile, with Halloween just around the corner, the Ontario Health Ministry has urged Ontarians not to go trick-or-treating this year. Rowena Papasin, ABS-CBN News.